offense out there, led by Adrian Martinez. He'll
with the Khalil Twins, 340, 320, 325. Seeing this kind of size and depth on the D-line is refreshing to see as a Nebraska fan.
Here's Brody Belt breaking loose, and that's good enough for a first down out past the 36.
Brody. But losing a guy like Devon Ezigbo, 1,000-yard rusher last year, it's going to be some big shoes to fill for Nebraska offense this year.
Belt still in the backfield along with Martinez. Martinez, the second-year quarterback, incomplete, intended
for him this week. He's focusing on the grind, just getting better with each day.
10-letter winners lost 7 starters off of last year. Martinez, they always want to work quickly with precision, stay within the process. Over the middle, got a man wide open over the middle, complete, and the first down by Cade Warner. Warner down inside the 10, tripped up down to the 7-yard line of the catch by heading down to the field. Boy, Cade Martinez has looked good, or Cade Warner has looked good this spring, huh?
Yeah, he's been extra consistent. He's got the most playing experience of the bunch outside of Jay as well.
That was a 58-yard gain. Here is Martinez, flips it out to Warner again, and Warner stopped just short.
Adrian, the opportunity to run the ball, but if he needs that outlet, they're always going to be there for him.
Belt with it again and walks in. Brody Belt with the first touchdown for the Red Squad in Nebraska's annual red-white game. Annual red-white game.
Offense, 5 players in the backfield. 5-yard
and there is a flag on the play, so that'll come back. Motion in the backfield. Also had a terrific spring for Nebraska, 5 in the pattern. Martinez will keep, and it opens up right up the middle for Adrian Martinez. And that time, no flag and a touchdown for the Red. One receiver in Javion McQuinney. Him up the middle. Boy, nifty move there. And a first down by Jalen Bradley, you know, to help himself out for the spring, huh, Damon?
It's got showcased a ton today.
Bradley back into the backfield along with Andrew Bunch, and here is Bradley again spinning loose.
Defensive line.
Miles Jones motions out. Give it to Bradley again, and you see the quick feet in the backfield. And 6 returning, or 5 returning starters, 6 lost from last year's Nebraska defense. There's Bradley again, and nothing there. Has primarily worked at that outside linebacker spot this spring. Bunch back to throw. Coverage there. Cam Taylor takes the fair.
Nebraska offense to fill that void.
And I would assume it's the offensive production there, Damon, that you think is the biggest loss between Morgan and Devine?
Yeah, there's 2 things right away. It's the leadership that both Morgan and the second-year new guys, or guys that are arriving in June and July. That's a tough way to make a living, so you want them to kind of get it going this spring.
Wyatt Mazur motions out. 3 or 4 games into the season, so his production much better over the back half of the season. Nebraska, of course, last year started.
Here you see Cam Taylor returning punts. Of course, J.D. Spillman out today, but an electrifying punt returner himself.
Isaac Armstrong kicks that out of his field for Nebraska. Will look very different in the fall than it does here in the spring game today.
Of course. But these guys today, they have a good opportunity to show. He can do a number of things. He can catch the ball in the backfield like you just saw there. He's really good in open space, as you saw in the first drive. So it's a nice grab there by number something that they really have to master.
Martinez flips it out into the flat, the screen. Down inside the
moving space, you know, get some things out in the flat and be a huge weapon down the field for this team.
Yeah.
You know, for those linebackers committing to the run, for these tight ends to find some open lanes and really make an impact.
Incomplete.
Great passer, but he's a deceptively a good runner as well.
Bunch over the middle, incomplete. 41 on extra points, 14 of 18 field goals. Maybe the most impressive part of Pickering's performance last year in his freshman year is that he never missed more than 1 field goal in a game. So despite being 14 of 18, never backed those up, always able to respond and not let a miss knock that one through. Also NBA experience. He's known as a guy who can recruit. Brody Belt back out there in the backfield along with Martinez. Belt will take the handoff. An interior gain of two on that play by Belt. And drug down from behind, Garrett Nelson.
Just, you know, for me, I've got so many connections to this university going all the way back to my grandfather's.
Weekend as well, you've got your staff put together. How are you looking forward to the challenges and also the benefits of what Nebraska can help you accomplish?
Yeah, there's a lot of things, over 90,000 in this stadium. And then again, I know every season ticket has been sold out at Pinnacle Bank next year. So again, it's great. You know, you see these kids walk around here, the support that they're getting is second to none.
Coach, before we let you go, we did.
Anybody knows Doc, you know, he's, I walk around, the first guy to go to is Doc. I'm second to him right now. We were a good team. And, you know, when I brought him to Iowa State, we had a great system on both ends of the floor. And I'm excited to have Doc back on my staff.
Coach, you'll be an outstanding addition to Class Act. Welcome.
Bulls.
It's been a very important spring for a now healthy Miles Jones.
Certainly is an opportunity for both Bradley and Jones to make a statement here, David. Do you believe that that backfield looks a lot different in the?
It's hard to pencil in impact, especially as American attests to. When you don't get here until June or July, it is tough to just plug and play.
And one white back out there. Into the back end, dropped on a strong play by Deontay Williams. He got a flag in the backfield as well, but stopped short of the line to gain.
Yeah, and talking to these defensive coaches. Yeah, wide Mizzou here in the backfield now. Coming in for Belt.
Mizzou tries to slip through the tackle, but made in the backfield to play.
Step up and supply some good depth.
Cassidy, a walk on out of Pius. Wide open out there. Reeled in to the first down by Austin Allen. Great throw from Mark.
It's good football right there.
Here is Mizzou out of the backfield for another first down inside the 13. But
inline tight end, they can flex him out as a hybrid type. And guys, again, we talk about hand in hand with the offensive line and the running backs do with this offense, and that's manipulating the second level defenders between the hashes.
Martinez keeps. Here's Martinez, pulls down the high snap, flips it, tries to hit Allen. Here for Martinez. On fourth down, and he'll be touched up and sacked. This white squad is going against one of the best Nebraska has had in a while. You look at the Davis twins, the ball's on the ground there. Picked up by the white squad, but you look at the Davis.
340, you got Carlos Davis, 325. That kind of size is big, man. You got these good running offenses in the Big Ten. But, oh,
picked off right through the hands, and picked off.
Markel Desmute.
It was Desmute.
False start here.
Execution, no mistakes, regardless who's out there. And we've seen a few mistakes here early on, just as Brody Belt with a gain of about
three here in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Big recruiting weekend, obviously, here on campus as well. And that certainly helps. As Martinez sidearms it over the middle. Got it! Touchdown! Martinez drills one to Jerron Woodyard for the touchdown.
And that's something that this offense has got to understand. It's going to be a lot of scramble plays. Martinez has the ability to extend the play, and that you can see him right here eluding the tackler, rolling to his left, throwing back right, finds Woodyard. Heck of a play.
Jerron Woodyard.
You know, I got to talk to him a little bit earlier in the year, and, you know, I'm just excited for the team. I think he's establishing, you know, a bunch of high-character guys, establishing, you know, some high expectations for the program. So, you know, just really looking forward and excited to see what they can do. A lot of memories walking out here. You know, it's almost 7 years ago. It doesn't seem like that long.
As always, we appreciate your time.
I appreciate it. Thanks.
Tremendous ambassador for the university.
Under some pressure, rolling to his right. Just throws it away, and that defensive front for Nebraska. Pressure off the edge, stepped up, got rid of it. Completion. Toss out of the flat incomplete.
Well, to be that guy.
I
guys, they really challenged him last year. You know, sometimes you see pressure there from the outside and quick hitter across to Miles. Had a terrific game last year against Bethune-Cookman, where he really showed flashes and then didn't get much of an opportunity after that. Flag is thrown. Looks like it's going to be a hold.
And you see number 7 on the red defense there flying around, Mulberry. He's the offense.
He has taken over that leadership role. After the penalty, they'll back him up. And Bunch is dropped off the edge. Looked terrific. Fair catch was called for. We're going to have a penalty.
Interference, kicking team, number 49. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
He came in and jumped on the bench, no warm-up, hit 275 about 6 to 8 times. Looked at me and was like, that's all you lifting? You know, from that day forth, I was like, yeah, I got to.
His 275, so I guess that's a little more impressive.
Oh, man, goodness. He still looks like he can play.
Geraftel
on tempo they want to move with.
To command the offense and be the maestro. So many young guys. You guys heard me ask the question yesterday when they're waiting for some of the skill guys. They need to see him be the benchmark, the tone setter at the quarterback spot.
Nice defensive play there for Avery Anderson.
Being able to whip the ball kind of like a sidearm baseball throw sometimes is something that this kid really possesses.
Springboard for Adrian Martinez. So he's been extremely integral as we take a look at a very, very gifted athlete in Luke McCaffrey.
Talk about Luke McCaffrey, who was given an opportunity to play quarterback. Many schools around the country recruiting McCaffrey. Ed, who played for the Broncos, had a terrific career in the NFL. And here is McCaffrey.
You can really see, man. He can turn the corner.
That those two impose on a lot of these other offensive guys.
Right.
McCaffrey's just out here playing.
Here's Bradley again. Kicks it outside and has some room. David, you have to be impressed with what you see from Jim.
High school playing weight in terms of how he feels from a lightness standpoint, and it's really helped his confidence. I told him before this game started, just go back to relaxing and having fun. Don't.
On this red squad here, the 6'3", 320-pound senior out of Dallas, Texas, a transfer from Oklahoma State as McCaffrey flips it out in the flat to Christian Banker. His body is in the film room, all those things you like to see out of somebody who's going to be a leader. And here he comes again with pressure up the middle. What a throw, great grab, McCaffrey. 14 yards on the completion from McCaffrey to Jones. McCaffrey looks over the middle. Flips it out of the flat. Nice defensive play there. Jalen Bradley takes the ball. Offsides on the defense.
Defense, number 22, 5 yard
positions.
McCaffrey to his left. Into the end zone. Has a man. And knocked away at the last minute.
League, as I mentioned earlier, he's 6'2", has the length, has the recovery speed, just got to keep playing with that confidence. He's a guy who definitely should see some time with the next level in the NFL, but it's up to him. It's about a choice to come in every day, understanding that you got to be a pro about your work, you got to watch film, got to put in the work.
So in there to try a field goal from about 33 away is Pickering. Pickering knocked his belt with a nice carry of gain of about 12 yards. It's
ball came
stripped out of there at the end. Lever, the redshirt freshman out of O'Neill, Nebraska. Carry there by Belt.
What we were most encouraged about was, you know, the leadership of this team coming in, and after that 0-6 start, they came in and spoke to them. I think it's definitely catapulted that turnaround that these guys had at the end of the year.
First down there on the carry by Belt. To that, the reception by Andre Hunt, who has had a good spring, and here is Federal on the carry. Federal out in space. That's a 14. Belt trying to strip it away.
7 the first year, 4-6 the first year in Nebraska.
Here. here in Lincoln. Great play up front. Five in the pattern, three to the top of the screen. Bendrell tries across the middle. Complete. That's going to be very near a first down.
Space and empty, isolating them on those linebackers, allowing them to go one-on-one, get a little choice.
Bendrell with the hard pump fake. Now rolls out of pressure. And a nice grab out there in the... Give to Wyatt Mazur. Mazur has good feet.
He was actually the MVP of the spring game last year.
That's right.
Had a heck of a game last year, so glad that he's headed to a senior year looking for MVP.
Nice career. 11 for 76 last year and a touchdown. Finds him there under the flat. And that's another element to Mazur's game.
They're trying to catch the defense off balance to get that first down. It's going to be close.
Mazur. Bendrell gets him set up in a hurry, and here is Mazur in there for the touchdown. Wyatt Mazur. First touchdown for the White on the day. Check that, that is the red.
Down, it can really work to offensive advantage.
Fifth carry for 15 yards for Mazur, and that touch extra point is 10 play.
I think playing a team like Ohio State early would do this team a lot of good. You know, playing a team with that kind of talent early. There's a nice play there by Cam Taylor.
Field incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. Punt in over in. Fair catch called for and pulled in by Cam Taylor.
Holding receiving team number 89. 10-yard penalty from the end of the kick. First down.
Game. You know, you lose a game like that early. Sometimes it takes the kids, the guys, a couple games to get their mojo back. As you see Belt here catching the screen. Guys about, you know, it's never as good as you think. It's never as bad as you think. End of the year, these guys kind of turned it around, and they saw, you know,
so something to work on.
Yeah. the hidden yards of this game is you see the tight end across the middle. They're catching that. Stay in position.
Bendrell pulls that down.
Gonna have a hold here.
Offense number 50, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Time ticking away here. The second quarter, across the middle again. Nice reception by 62. The longest current streak in the country by a long ways. Hard field goal. Barrett Pickering, the sophomore out of Birmingham, Alabama. Kick is up and it is just inside. What Nebraska hopes is a much better second season under Scott Frost. So we start second half action with the White and the ball, and there is the scramble by Andrew Bunch, the 6'1" on the carry for Andrew Bunch. Bradley with the carry, he's gonna be stacked up. Give here again to Bradley. Back in on the day, 12 carries, 57 yards, a long of 8, almost 5 yards per carry on the day for Jalen Bradley, the sophomore out of Bellevue. In the middle through the hand.
Really low, can really drop his weight and turn the corner. I think that's going to really work in his advantage and really allow him to excel into, you know, the next part of his game. Young now, looking up to him as an example of how to lead yourself.
Bendrell down the field, a wide open tight end.
Screen is nothing but an extended run, so the better you get at it, you know, the more defenses.
Call is loose and pops up.
They call that an incomplete pass there.
Get it? This BTN standout play presented by Discover and Auto Owners.
Thank you. the style of Wisconsin. It may fit the style of Northwestern or Indiana, depending on where you're playing that week. It's just giving them a luxury.
Team.
This is always a time for.
That's tipped around and incomplete. Miles Jones in the backfield along with Munch.
Good opportunity, a challenge rather, for Alex Davis and Ferguson, guys like that, to step up and really make an impact as pass rushers.
How has ownership of this football team come for you?
It's been coming along good. And well, you know, what we have right now, I'm excited about. You know, and you just have to focus on that at the end of the day. Have to make with what you have, you know. And I really believe in the guys we have here and the technical issues myself. And he never once doubted me, never didn't have the confidence in me and the rest of the guys. And you know, it's contagious. And he got my mechanics right. And just from all sides of the game, he does it so well.
The sky is truly the limit. The sky is pretty high, boss.
Thank you. You know,
yeah, so much maturity with that guy right there. He understands that, you know, no moment is in. And the guys who come back to help with that leadership aspect is going to be huge. But Adrian is definitely leading that forefront.
Jamie Nance had a step there, but
those are things that he may struggle with early, you know, coming from high school. A lot of things he wasn't exposed to, but you know, he has great
tempo and didn't really have a chance to get to much X's and O's, and the kids didn't even know the drills that they were trying to put in. The progress they feel they have made this spring over last spring is significant.
Yeah, and that just comes with comfort, you know, getting in tempo with this kind of offense.
Reception complete there by
a lot of times that allows his offense to kind of spruce things up as opposed to just doing the zone.
After Nebraska's spring game, here's our first look at Matt Masker in there to quarterback now for this white squad. Masker is a 6'1". Masker under pressure by Nashawn Neal. Nashawn Neal.
That's been a gradual growth with him, but you see he's getting a couple. Oh. As you see, the ball sails over for a touchdown there. That's a so a good start to Masker's day.
That's right.
Nice first drive for him.
Bad at all. There's Luke McCaffrey back out there at quarterback for the Red Squad. McCaffrey untouched. A little move there on the near side.
Holding. Offense, 19, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, first down.
How much this Nebraska roster has changed in just 15 months. 101 players added to the roster.
Getting guys who were bought in was important for him. You know, getting guys who understood that it's not about them, it's about the team and everyone.
Gretna, Nebraska, 5'11", 225. Talk about thump. Nowhere for McCaffrey. Let's see if they get this final playoff here. And well, back to play here in quarter number four. Luke McCaffrey back out there, quarterback incomplete.
That have happened here, and people just love Nebraska football. Others is the purpose of life, not doing everything for ourselves, but doing something for other people, whether it's your teammate or whether it's for other people that have been affected by things Nebraska's been affected.
As well, incomplete pass intended. Many of those towns impacted, people impacted by the flooding. We came from Nebraska and Southwest Iowa. Much of that flooding has been. Masker throws that away. He said that, you know, in his 10 years of being with this offense at various places, various levels, from Oregon to UCF and now here.
Spring, but come season time, these guys will be seasoned, they'll be ready to go. You know, periodically throughout the spring, and sometimes you may worry about how that's hurting your quarterback play, how your quarterback is, you know, improving throughout the spring, not having his top.
6'3", 245-pound sophomore from Central City, who's listed as 55 on the roster, but actually wearing 57. Now quarterbacking for this Red Squad. Goes to his left. Was he touched up?
How are you feeling with the progress?
I'm happy with the progress for the most part. I feel like the spring's been a great spring. The younger guys underneath me, summer in the fall camp, that we're going to keep improving.
You know, it starts, if you want to have the type of success you're after, it starts with the guys up.
Coach Tony coming in. I mean, he's making sure them guys is a tight-knit group. I mean, he's making sure they're having fun each and every day. I mean, he keeps them to make them feel smothered, shake them up a little bit. But I mean, Adrian, we got one of the best that do it. He's elusive. He don't really get shook up too much. But yeah, with quarterbacks like that, we kind of just got to keep him in the box and just make sure he stay contained. And for the most part on defense, we just got to be confident. We got to go out there every playmaking. I mean, we just got to go out there and just keep the competition alive, keep the playmaking alive. And I feel like we're gonna be all right. We got a lot of people, guys capable that can make plays.
Best wishes the rest of the season.
Appreciate that.
Guys, he's become the poster child for a little bit of the ability to stay with it while continuing to get better.
We're really honest with him and say, you want to be a pro and you're not doing anything like a pro. So taking care of your body, to look at a film, to work and saw how his season turned last year.
Yeah, it's interesting. Sport.
Wiz, as you said, entering his senior year out of Elk Grove, California. Franklin High School, so highly recruited out of high school.
You're dealing with recruits such as LeVar. Go back to LeVar for a minute. A lot of times, he understands technique. He understands that he has to win at the line. And I think he's every year he's grown in his physicality. And, as this final quarter kind of ticks down, I just realized I've covered more sprint games than I've actually played in. My last time going out there, I had to beg Coach Pelini to let me go out there. But,
86,000 here today to watch this annual Red White
Day. Even guys who come from California, Georgia, Alabama at times. When the national
McCaffrey and this red offense.
Nice tough run there.
Austin Hemphill. Pressure there for that
intent. Yeah. As a defense, when you have a defense that is stout, has some big boys in the middle who are making play.
Red white scrimmage. McCaffrey slides to his left, goes deep, has a man down there, and tipped away at the last second. Intended for playoff as time ticks away, and they do. Last play of the 2019 red white scrimmage. McCaffrey scrambles. Say he was touched up,